everybody. It's Fran again with yet another edition of the Francast. All audio every Thursday so far. Trying to keep it going as a weekly thing. And this week, I wanted to talk about another very human thing. That's regret. It's kind of strange. Regret. It's often confused with remorse. In fact, remorse and regret are often interchanged with one another in language, but they're very different things. Remorse is a penitent emotion. It's not really the same. Rueing is not the same as regret. Now, regret is specifically desiring the past to be different. It is wishing that you had taken a different path, that if you had made a decision that your life could have been very different, that things would have turned out differently. And in this sense, regret is perhaps the most human of all emotions, because it requires us to live in the past, which is another thing that seems to be unique to humans, although we really don't know for sure. But regret is the most futile of all desires, because inherent in regret is the desire to change the past, which is impossible. The past is done. It's over. It doesn't exist anymore. It can't be changed. So the very idea of regret is pointless, utterly pointless. The past cannot be changed. So to have regret is a completely useless emotion. But there isn't one among us who doesn't think about the past and wonder, how would my life have been if I had only done this? And truly, if you would ask me 20 years ago if I have any regrets, I'd probably give you a long list of things that I really would have wanted to have done differently. A path not taken. But honestly, it's only been probably the last 5 years or so, really very recently, that I've had a completely different way of looking at the past. From my vantage point here, in 2023, when I look back and think about decisions I made, think about where I was at the time, think about things that I've been through, really, when I look at it objectively, outside of desire, need, emotion, I really think that everything panned out exactly as it was going to, that there really could not have been any other kind of outcome, that there was really nothing that I could have done that would have made anything any different. It just seems true. I think the past is like that, when you really boil it down, because it's largely not up to you, these decisions. The paths that we take are largely not up to us. They are paths that are presented before us, and really the only decision we make is either to walk forward or not. And that doesn't really seem to be much of a decision to make when the path is presented to you. But it's really the complex and unpredictable, unfathomable decisions of other people and our relation to the decisions of other people that really create the paths that are presented to us in our lifetimes anyway. So regret is somewhat of a fallacy too, because maybe there really was nothing else that we could have done, even if there was another choice. Maybe we did make the best choices. Maybe even when things went terribly, that these things were necessary. One of the strange things about looking back at the past, from a vantage point of being later in years, this futility of choice, or the illusion of choice, it becomes more solidified. When I think back at the worst things that ever happened to me, the worst situations I found myself in, the tragedies, the heartbreaking losses, the real grief, it was all inevitable. I think there is this inevitability to everything that happened in my life. Here's a strange thing about regret, about wishing the past to be different. If you could change the past, if you could remove the terrible events, if you could somehow prevent the tragedies, you're essentially desiring the you that now exists to not exist anymore. Because the truth is that the most terrible things that ever happened to you, the worst crises, the most overwhelming grief, these things, these terrible things that on one hand you would want to have never happened to you, they are the things that make you who you are. Without struggle, without pain, without tragedy, you will never find out who you are. You will never know who you really are. And the real regret should be a life that is unfulfilled by being padded or being too protected. If you have a cozy life and you never get out and do anything, you never take any risks, well, you probably might have a lot of regrets. Then again, maybe not. But I do know that it is in the crucible of tragedy, struggle, pain. It is in these things, it's through these things, that we discover who we really are. And I know for a fact that I would not be the person that I am today if I wouldn't have survived everything that I have survived. That all the terrible things, I might wish them away, I might wish that they never happened, but I realize in a very real, impactful way that largely those really hard things that I had to face, that's really where I found out who I really was. And so, for myself, I can't say that I have regrets, because if I could change the past, if I could alter my path, I would not be who I am, and I would be denying myself the discovery of my own true nature, which took a long time and took a lot of suffering to discover. This is one of the reasons that when you're young, particularly when you're a young adult, you really have no clue who you are or what you want to do in life. I know that I didn't. It's really only from my vantage point of being late in life that I have any perspective on the things that have really meant anything to me. So I do have remorse, but I really don't have regret, because as much as I would want to change my past, I am very aware that without the past, I would not be in the present. And so regret is useless. And regret puts us in the past where we really shouldn't be anyway. We really need to be in the now, because the now is all that ever does exist. And the now is all that ever will exist. You only ever have what's happening right now. It's always the truth. So. Well, thanks again for listening to another rambling Francast. And thanks, as always, to all my patrons over on the Patreon who make all this possible, including the Francast. So thank you, thank you. Everybody on the Patreon. I'll be back doing something somewhere in the lab. We'll see.